with Eddie Olchek alongside and Ray Ferraro down at the ice. This is Mike Emery. October, first month of the hockey year, and a great time for a strong start to the season. And before the faceoff, here's Eddie.
The fans are ready, that's for sure. We're kicking off the regular season with a tremendous amount of energy. These two teams will need to settle it down early in order to walk away with the win.
The players are more than set. They have gotten through the preseason, they've made the team, and they're ready to make an impact. We are ready as well to start off game number one of the regular season. And it has begun. An angle to Keith. It's redirected. Saved there. There was a time it was hard to do, but not so much anymore. Putting the net back on, it's come off. Drop. They lock up, and that's a good job by the winger. He was standing in the lane and got some of it. Now it's directed to Niederreiter. Pitched that one back in deep. Peterborough's controlling play now in the defensive zone. Steps across that line. Mishandled thanks to the roadblock. Puck loose. Laid on to Silverberg. Slid to Burns. And at an angle to Silverberg. Side to side they go, trying to generate something. Fires, score! Didn't take too long, 1-0.
Always interesting, guys, after the first goal is scored, whether the team that scored is going to continue to attack or whether they'll sit back a little bit.
Rochester's ahead by one goal here in the first period. A lot of time still left to play, but getting one and breaking the tie was huge. Rock drop, face off one, and the winger stepped right in.
Assisted by number two, Duncan Keith. By number 33.
Rochester's in their own end and on the move.
4 minutes, 31 seconds.
He takes that point pass. Passing one off now to Lindberg. Is able to move on in. That attack shut right down. Intercepts that pass on the attack. Lost the puck, just couldn't get by. Got it at the point. Smith tripped and a penalty should be coming. The Firebirds have possession in their own end. Moves up the wing. And the goalie to the bench. The extra man's on. Peterborough sent to the box for 2 minutes. It's tripping.
I'm going to give credit to the puck carrier here. He kept his legs moving. He forced the back checker to reach in and take him off his feet.
The Firebirds will send out their power play unit for the first time.
Just because it's your power play doesn't mean you can take a nap here. You have to work hard and continue to generate chances.
8 minutes, 45 seconds.
Puck flipped into the bench and the whistle stops play. A little under 9 minutes have been played here in the first. It's a 1-0 game. The puck's dropped, and that's a great job tying the man up on that faceoff. Terrific determination by Hamilton. Puck is thrown to Richardson. A shot, blockered away. Gathered up again by Richardson. One-time blast, may not have been intentional, but he got it anyway. Rochester's along the wing at center ice. A one-timer, save! He got all of it, and so did he.
Anderson's presence of mind to continue to battle and never give up keeps this puck out of the net.
Puck dropped in the logjam, and the winger reached in and got it. Used that stick like a magic wand. Cleared it out of there. Gathered up by Hamilton. Niederreiter's got this one between the blue lines. Shoots one. Wow, what a glove save. Can he make him chase it? And now the whistle signals stoppage of play and we'll get the penalty. The Chislers are assessed a minor penalty for delaying the game. That puck was shot out of play.
Anytime you shoot the puck from your defensive zone out into the crowd without touching anybody, it's a delay of game.
A 5-on-3 power play. It may seem like a sure goal, but sure things are never sure in hockey.
One of the biggest problems on a 5-on-3 is teams are too cautious. They don't shoot the puck enough, and they make it too easy for the penalty killers to kill it off.
Smart recovery by Smith. And freezes play for the whistle.
Quick's able to make a relatively easy glove save because he's in the perfect spot.
Nice face-off work. Directing that one to Svechnikov. Took care of that one. Gets that one on a cross. Outstanding body contact.
He's often the object of a target. He's so good, nobody wants to give him much room, but he gets tagged there.
I don't think the puck here ever thought that this player was going to come in and make this big, huge hit.
Puck drop, tie up, and help from the winger. They must retreat and start back again. To Berglund, trying to get it back out of the zone. Slugged back out again by Berglund. Gets the pass through to start a play. Leads that charge into the zone. Huge hit in open ice.
If you're looking for this type of open ice hit, you better have a good angle, and that's exactly what happened. This is a big-time major collision.
Look out, here it comes. Clears the zone. The Firebirds go back to pick it up. Time is dwindling on this power play. Points it. Propelled to Keith. Good place to shoot from. Great save. Peterborough's penalty kill was outstanding.
Penalty killing requires work, it requires determination, and you can't win if your killers let you down. They did an outstanding job.
They lock up from the draw, and the teammate puts the grab on it. To the backhand. Crashed into him in open ice. He hangs on and gets the whistle.
Rochester's offense is predicated by laying the body on the opponents. They've been more physical early. They have the game's only goals, too.
Just under 7 minutes to go. Only one goal hanging on the board so far. So it's 1-0. The tie-up. He needed help, and he got it. Skates it into the zone. Right to the point. And move down to Barzell. A one-timer. Save! He just stopped one of the best. Solid, clean win. Pitching it to Perron. Steps in from the neutral zone. Using the point. Glides along the line. Takes that pass from the other point. And down to Lindberg. He's got that pass at the point. Pass to the blue line. Shoots. Locked away. Collected in the corner. Dishes it back. Out to the half wall. To Silverberg. Cut off that pass in the neutral zone. Possession in the zone. They've got all the gunners out. Couldn't make it through. Can't retain possession. Oh, that was close. Chip to Hamilton. The Firebirds through the neutral zone accelerate to the line. Dogged determination there by Niederreiter. Makes the stop and holds for the whistle. Okay, they win the draw. Cranks a blast! Wonderful stop! Good job on the draw. Looking to Neal. First period stats are final. We'll have some more entries as the second and third periods are forthcoming. It's a 1-0 game.
Tonight is our team poster giveaway. If you find a sticker on the inside cover of your program, go to Guest Services to receive your
Burns' team. Goal is the one we want to show you because it's the go-ahead goal as we head to intermission. Period two has begun. Let's see what happens here. They just keep working away, don't they? That's a free puck thanks to the play by Zucker. Picks it up back there. Rochester's along the wing at center ice. Tries to get it on net. Waffle boarded. To the point it comes. Let's it go. On to Werenski. Good, solid defensive play with the stick. Score!
Silverberg's able to get himself in position to one-time that puck to the back of the net.
Good work to get into the open to receive the pass, but that's a beauty of a dish. That opens up the pass lane, gives him time to shoot the puck.
The Firebirds have now enlarged their lead to 2-0. At the rate they're going in this game, they might make it 3 fast. They've won the faceoff. The Firebirds through the neutral zone continue with possession. That's a great deflection there. Good stick. Important interception there. Drives it. He wore that puck on a hard shot. Play stopped. That puck is just held.
Oh, the goaltender read this really well. He's down in the butterfly, and he's going to stop this all day.
Faceoff and a solid tie-up and help arrive. Good job.
The fans would love for this rookie to get that first goal.
And the referee's whistle has stopped play. A bit over 5 minutes completed in the second. 2 goals have been scored, both by one team. Defensive zone win. The Chislers are skating it up at neutral ice. Takes that pass. They score! It's only a 1-goal game now.
Goalie can't. cover everything, five hole is always a pretty good option.
The Chislers have gotten back to within one. Loads of time left in the game. We're in the second period.
I'd like to say that I think this game is going to open up and there's going to be all kinds of chances all over the place, but both teams have really adopted a never-give-an-inch style of play. I think this is tight checking right down to the final hole.
Nice play with the... Nothing more will come. And he dumps it in. Not able to do that well. Loose puck did not go very well. Looks over his options from the corner. Sends to the point. Cut that pass in his own end. Sliced down. Good pass off the boards. Sends it down low now. And he gets it back. Peter Burrows lugging it along in the defensive zone. Driving in from no man's land. And up to Perron. Gives it on a cross from the point. Out in front. Stared him down and made the save.
Now that's a solid save.
And he holds on and stops play.
Anderson's had a difficult night. Because he's not had many pucks to deal with, his concentration has had to stay sharp. A little bit of mental gymnastics in there.
A little under 8 minutes to go here in the second. So they've gotten one. Let's see if they can get another. Patrick's lost another draw. His team needs one. They need anything. They're behind. Trying to go to Patrick. Pass attempt to Neal. Scooped up by Zucker. From the outside. Outstanding save. Difficult opportunity. Snapping a pass to Niederreiter. Laid on to Werenski. Peter Burrows controlling play now up the wing. Fires a shot. Stick to side. Let's it rip. Terrific opportunity, but it's off the mark.
That was very close, but he missed opportunity with that shot.
Oh, snaps the shot. That puck was obstructed by a screen. Good intercept in his own end. He's got that pass and can look ahead. Back and forth they go between the points. At least he protected his goaltender. In with it now. Oh, broke it up. Decides to head for the corner. Pass cut, strong play.
Well, that's a bad turnover, Doc. When you're ahead, that puck has to be moved into a safe area of the ice 100% of the time. You can't deliver the puck much better than that, but the goalie says no chance. That's an excellent save.
Drama heightens in this final minute of the second period. The Firebirds on the move through center. Shoot! What a save! I was looking for the light to come on. No way he's getting by there. He throws it there. Shooter tempted to stare at the ceiling on that one. What a glove grab. Two periods have been played. And so, as we think back through the first two, we think ahead toward the third.
Look for our food donation boxes located throughout the concourse.
Rochester's got the lead at the end of the period, and their goaltender has made a huge difference in that. Here's just an example of his body of work. We'll be right back. Third period about to begin. The rearview mirror will help us with the first two, and so will Edza.
Peter Burrows. Turnovers in the first two periods, Doc, are the direct result of this score. They're lucky still to be in this game.
Interesting action in the first two periods. I wonder what we'll get as this third period has begun. up to the point. Taken to the slot. As that point pass as well. To the half wall. Puck collected. Slid to Neal. A big one-timer. Save. And decides to just cover it up and get the whistle. A little over 3 minutes have passed here in the third. And it is 2-1 the score in this one. The faceoff, the tie-up, and a solid job from the winger there. Rochester setting up an offense from the wing. Puts one on. And a save. He's done it again. That's another victory at the faceoff circle. Werenski's trying to work his way to center ice. Gains the zone. Stole that pass at a critical end of the ice. And they are in. Snapped off a wrist shot. Saved there. Clean win on the draw. The Chislers control the play through the neutral zone. Gives it to the point. Slid back across from one point to the other. Shoots. Saved with the pad. The Firebirds skated up on the side. Lets the shot fly. Great save. He slowed down a bit, and there'll be a hooking penalty called on this one. Peterborough's two-minute penalty is a minor, and the call is hooking.
This was okay about 10 years ago. Not anymore. That's a hooking call. This power play is too predictable. They have to find a way to change it up.
Absolutely. I think you're right, Eddie. Let's see what the team does here.
They didn't take advantage on the power play earlier in the game. Let's see if they can jump on the board here.
Cleared back by Richardson. Two players came. Oh, that was in the net. What happened?
The penalty killers have breathed new life into this game. Down a goal. They're trying to hang on by killing this penalty. They get an advantage, and they're able to cash in.
Peterborough's gotten the game even, and who knows what will happen next. Somebody's got to break this tie, or we'll do it in OT. And they've won the faceoff.
By number 26, Patrick Berglund, assisted by...
Dumped into the opposite corner by Alex Pietrangelo. Pitching this one to Barzal. Let's a shot go. Wonderful stop. Just a little under 9 minutes have gone by here in the third. The winds have shifted yet again. This game is back in a tie. That puck's loose, deflected away by Alex Pietrangelo. Sent on further, they'll have to return. Burns wants neutral ice. Snapped up that right wing to Silverberg. Cut that pass in his own end. Puck into the player's bench. They can't play it there. It'd be fun if they could. Solid win of the draw. Feeds the point. Puck ricocheted off the screen. That puck came free. Could have been handled better. That one's fired back out, and so more time will go off the penalty clock. Moving it to Silverberg. He gains the zone. Turned a shot on net. A magnificent pad save. Puck went into the player's bench. They can't play it there.
The Chiselers
need to acknowledge their goaltender after one of the better saves you will ever see. Somebody get this guy a steak. They took that draw and won it. Here he comes. Outstanding glove on a shot that changed direction. That faceoff is won. Lots on that to Hamilton. Recollected.
Great job by the goalie here. Lots of buzzing in his own, but he gets the stop and he'll settle things down.
Rochester's next game will be the first as they kick off a lengthy homestand. Good opportunity to string together a few victories. Critical faceoff win at that point. Receives that pass from the other side. The Chiselers, with a big penalty kill, were back at full strength.
I really don't see much difference between the two teams. For what we've seen tonight, they look like they are step by step and will be that way for the rest of the evening. It's almost like these teams are mirror images of each other. There's no room on the ice. Nobody has been able to spread out the play and generate a whole ton of scoring chances.
Now it's directed to Barzal. Enormous hit. He's crushed.
I really like the effort that he's trying there to generate a turnover by finishing his check.
Peterborough's in possession as they travel in the defensive zone. Propelled to Lindberg. Oh, a close call there.
That's a great scoring chance, but he just missed. He'll be looking to get the next one.
Collected by Niederreiter. Chip to Manson. The Chiselers with a neutral zone possession along the wing. Through the corner. Passing one off now to Burns. Nicely received at the point. Save. Couldn't get through. It's loose. Puck heads to the neutral zone. The attackers, of course, follow. Puck is thrown to Neal. And you thought open ice hitting was gone. A penalty has been called at a critical point in the game. And the power play unit comes out.
Well, what he was trying to do is try to get the puck, but unfortunately for him, he reached in and hooked around the player. Off to the penalty box he goes.
The Chiselers get their first power play of the game, and it is big.
The power play's excited to get out there. Those guys just about scrambled onto the ice as they get their initial chance of this game.
Directing that one to Perron. Pitching it to Patrick. To get behind the net. He's got it, but has to get rid of it. Oh, they got it out. They check the clock and prepare to defend some more. From that save, the puck is out of play, and we'll have a whistle.
Maybe he's shooting to pump up his Corsi numbers, because that has no chance of going in the net.
Under 3 minutes remaining. A hockey game is one of lead changes, and this one has seen its lead vanish. Takes that pass from the other point man. Good save there. Holds on and gets that whistle.
As soon as the shooter starts to release, as the goalie drops to the butterfly, hey, buddy, pick up your head. You might see he's down on his knees already.
Face-off win. Looking to Werenski. Trying to go to Neal. Two-on-one. Things are heating up with that hit.
Burns doesn't take a backseat to too many players. He is a skilled player, but he uses the body, and it really makes everybody aware.
Lobs it. Gets a blocker on it. Attacking from the boards. Forks it to Petrangelo. To the half wall. And he gets it back. Fires it to the point, to Neal. That shot came from right in front.
A quick developing play right in front. Almost looks like he's too close to the goaltender.
Pass attempt to DeBrusque. Gets across, looks over his options. Lets it go. Oh, he got it! You couldn't have chosen a better guy for that shot, or apparently a better guy to stop it.
That wasn't a very dangerous opportunity at all, but to be sure, the goalie drops to the butterfly and turns it aside.
Patrick's failed again. A lot of losses, but his team's still in this. Carries it on in from center. The Firebirds faced a power play at a key moment in the game and did away with it.
That's a brutal feeling. You're sitting in the penalty box after committing a penalty inside the last 5 minutes of the game. You have to have your penalty killers come through for you, and all you can do is hope.
Rochester's got possession in the defensive zone. He's got that point pass. Skilled play by Gardner. A strong pass to the right. Snapping a pass to Perron. Pitching this one to Patrick. Using the point, he's got it. That puck hit him on the way to the net. Muscled long to Smith. Fires. Great save, point blank.
The shooter thought he had a chance, but the goaltender robs him. What a stop.
Moving it to Berglund. Perfect wrister. Score!
It's been a hard-fought game here. This is such a late goal, it could be the game winner.
And that's the end of this one. The game has ended. Peterborough's been able to win this one, but they didn't do it in the normal way.
When you think of specialty team goals, you think of the power play, not when you're shorthanded, and they got some tonight.
And that takes care of game number one. It is a long season ahead, but a season designed to entertain hockey fans. We hope you enjoyed this one. We did. For Eddie Olczyk and Ray Ferraro, Mike Emmerich saying good evening.